Hey, welcome back to the Crabby Dice. Today we're going to look at Prodigals Club from one of my favorite designers right now, Vladimir Succi. And yes, after I did Last Will, I was going to definitely tackle this one next. So I won't go into the review or my thoughts on the game right now. Go to the other link below for my review and playthrough. This one's going to be more of a sanitized look on just the setup and rules in case you just want to learn how to play and have your own thoughts on if you like it or not. All right, so what is Prodigals Club? Well, it's half worker placement game and half tableau game where you're going to be using cards and tokens on your own tableau to either lose money, lose votes, or insult people. Alright, so there's a bunch of things going on. It looks very daunting. I mean, there's a lot of components in the game, but it's actually not that hard to understand. Alright, so three things before we start. Please subscribe, please comment, please like my videos. Everything helps in the world of algorithms online. Also, I'm gonna break this video down differently. Usually I talk about the general overview, then the setup, and then the rules. But in this one, because the modules are very unique and you play with two out of three or all three, so it's four different ways to play out of the box. So I'm gonna be tackling the overview, then each module separately and how to set them up and the rules for them, and you can decide how to play. Or play with all of them like I have here. All right, so let's get started with the general overview. All right, the general setup, turn structure, how to win, and all that jazz. So I'm not gonna be talking about the individual modules for that, go below, but we'll talk about some general concepts and the main board here first before tackling all those competitions slash modules. All right, so for setup, before we even talk about anything, every deck that you see or every stack of tiles always has one or two symbols. Always stack the ones above the twos. For example, these tiles here have twos underneath, these tiles two have two. So when you shuffle them, don't shuffle them all together, shuffle the twos together and then the ones, and then stack the ones on top of the twos. So even the decks of cards are all the same. For the middle here, there's a couple of things we need to check for setup. There's the stack of cards in the middle. There's always going to be five, and you're going to take the stack of cards dealing with the number of modules you're playing with. So in this case, I'm playing three modules. That's why this deck of cards has all three symbols. If you're playing with only two modules, take the deck of cards that only deal with those two modules that you're playing with. For example, if you're playing elections and possessions, you'll be dealing with the down arrow and the money bags. All right, and then at the start of the game, you can flip this over and you're ready to go. These two game boards over here, they are affected by the modules also. So here you can see a little icon. This is for all three modules. You'll play with this top half here. The other side is if you're playing two modules. And also this bottom board here works the exact same way. If you're playing three modules, play with the six tokens that are here. If you're playing two modules, play with the four token side here. Now, you'll only use the tokens of the modules you're playing with, obviously. So if you're playing with all three, you'll put all six tokens out there. All right, that's basically it for the setup. Everything else is for the individual modules. Now we'll go into the turn structure and how to win. All right, so what is the goal of the game? We'll just tackle that right away. The goal of the game is to have the lowest accumulated score between all competitions, right? So if you're playing with all three competitions, you'll add your score for all three competitions. Whoever has the lowest score, golf rules, wins. All right, so that's how you win. Now, how long is the game? Normally it would last five rounds, but it could end early. So if any player gets to zero or below for any competition, it'll trigger the end game. So let's say in round four, Billy got to zero votes in the election track here. That'll trigger the end game. All right, so you gotta keep an eye on that. Alright, so now let's talk about what all the phases of a round are. So normally there's five, there could be six if you're playing with both of these modules, but we'll just tackle the default five. So the first is the setup. So the setup for the main board is you just flip over the next card that you need. Phase two is placing your errand boys. That's the worker placement aspect of the game. So again, we'll tackle the individual modules individually, but let's talk about the main board here and certain things that you can do on the main board. So if you go straight up here, you just take the card here into your hand. Easy enough. If you go down here, this is changing the player order. This is the current player order. So if I wanted to go last, I can go last and everything gets shifted over. For example. when you go down here, you do take a bonus token with you. So, you, for example, you lose $2. And then at the end of the round, you put the token back. And then lastly, on the main board, another thing you can do is go here to pick up this special tile. This tile, you only have it for a round. You have to bring put it back at the end of the round, but it just gives you two of any icon for the round. So if you really needed a dog symbol and a horse symbol that round, you can pick up this tile and it'll give you those symbols. All right, now phase three is doing the actions. So I'll just show you with an example. So with all the cards that you gather during the turn, let me just draw a bunch of cards here. You're gonna go on your own tableau. Let me just bring all these to my hand. And you're gonna be playing cards to try to lose money, lose votes, and lose reputation, right? So there's two kinds of cards in the game. There's white cards and black cards. White cards, think of them like one-offs, like events. So as soon as you use the card once, you discard it. So for example here, I would move my lady to the left up to three times, and then I would discard this card to the discard pile. Black cards all go to your tableau here. So you have spots for six cards. If you want to play another card, you'd have to discard a card that you already have on your tableau. Right? And then also in this phase, you get to activate your cards. So by activating, you slide the card down to show the check mark, which means you activated it, and you just do the effect that's in the top right. So this one, you would lose a dollar. This one, you can move a guy down for every culinary symbol, and so on and so on. You just have to look at the book for the iconography. This one, you let move a reputation person to the left or the right twice. And this one actually gives you a special ability, but no effect ability. So you don't have to activate him to do something. He just gives you an ability that triggers all the time. Which I think this one is if you sell a blue burrow card, you get two less dollars. There you go. So that's this phase. In this phase, you will also collect these if you're playing with the election module, and these you get to put together. I'll show you that during that setup and that explanation on how these work. All right, and that's basically the overview. Then there's a cleanup step at the end, and in between there might be two special phases, but I'll talk about that during the election and society competitions. All right, so let's tackle one of the modules right now. All right, let's tackle the election board first. Very easy. So set up, pick the side of the board according to the number of players. You'll be playing with this election board, which just keeps track of the number of votes you have. And for your player area, give everyone one of these symbols that has a no down vote on the back. So that's gonna be their starting tile. I'll show you how these work shortly. All right, so you're gonna be setting out your cards just like usual. Look underneath, two whites and a black. You just take them from the appropriate deck. All right, let's talk about all these spots and what they mean. So if you put your token here, you'll just lose a vote, affect the track. If you put your token on one of these three, you'll take one of the available tracks here. So you either take these cards in this tile, or these cards in this tile. This tile fell off. Oh, there you go. Now, if you put your token here, you're gonna lose a vote and pick one of these two tiles. And if you put your token here, you'll get more megaphones for the Hyde Park extra phase before the end of the round. So we'll talk about that now. So only if you're playing with this module, you do a Hyde Park phase right before the cleanup phase, which everyone's gonna calculate how many megaphones they have. So whoever put their token here is gonna gain extra megaphones. But if you didn't, just your base megaphones, just add it up all together. Whoever played the most, whoever has the most megaphones, is gonna lose the votes according to the track here. The column that you're gonna look at is according to the round tracker. So as you go up, you're gonna be affecting different columns here. So let's say in the first round, it's two votes here, and everyone else is gonna lose one vote. Now, whoever played the least amount of megaphones is actually gonna go up a vote, right? So there's three different statuses: the lowest, the most, and everyone else. All right, so just calculate it that way. So that's how this works. So now, how do you reach zero, or what's your score at the end of this? It's basically the amount of votes you have. So at the end of the game, Whether you played all 5 rounds or not, your end score for this module is just calculated wherever your vote token is on. So if it's on 20, you have 20 points worth here. And remember, the accumulation of all the scores of all the competitions you're playing is your final score. All right, now let's just talk about the tiles and some of the cards here before we move on. So the way these tiles work is, let's say during the round I picked up a couple of these tiles. Well, I'll use all 4 just to show you an example. When you get these, you connect them to your existing tile to create extra symbols. So for example, I'm just gonna play this fast. All right, so for example, now I would have an extra cutlery symbol, a carriage symbol, dog symbol, and horse symbol because I've placed them this way. All sides have to match. The question mark is a wild, so it would be kind of pointless to connect 2 wilds together because you don't get a symbol out of it. But these only affect iconography or icons, so that when you're doing different actions, you get extra icons. All right. Now let's just talk about some of these cards and how they work. So again, black cards stay on your tableau, and basically this symbol means if you ever play a conservative card, here you lose 2 votes whenever you played a conservative card that turn. And there's the same thing for the L, which is liberal card. All right, there's megaphones, which you can get megaphones for every round here, and there's just different ways to lose votes. So there you go, it's just losing votes and gaining megaphones. So that's this module. Let's jump on to the next one. All right, the society module. So again, setup very easy. Look at the side of the board that you're playing on. You'll be placing the Beatrice tiles here, and every round you'll flip over 1 during the setup. You'll also set up your cards as per normal according to what's there. So here you put 1 black and 1 white card, and so on. Here will be 1 white card. All right, so on your player board, the only extra thing, if you're playing with this module, you'll be playing with this board. If you're not playing with this module, toss this board back in the box. So you'll set the people out as displayed above here. So you'll have 4, I guess, influencers that you're trying to lose influence, so they're going to be moving down. Your end score for this module is the accumulation of the spots where all these people are. So right now my score is 14 plus 14 plus 12 plus 12. So just look at what's underneath, and that's their score, which is pretty horrible. You're trying to move them down. All right, that'll make more sense when we talk about all these worker placement spots that are available, and that's where you can move down those people. So again, if you place your marker, you just follow the iconography and move down those people. So if you go here, you move 1 person down 1. If you go here, you can move 1 or 2 people in any direction. If you go here, you move 1 or 2 people down 1, and so on and so on. Just keep in mind that when you're moving people down, they can't occupy the same space. So I couldn't move this guy down 1 because he'll hit the lady over here. I don't know how else to say it, but that's it. Now, if you're playing with this module, every turn there's an extra phase, which is the Beatrice phase over here, where she's gonna affect everyone, sort of like a global event, and you'll just look at this icon and perform it. So here, for every token you have in the red and yellow tracks, so on the left and the right, for example here, they would go up 1. So here's the go up 1. So basically all these tokens here, like this one, go up 1, and this one go up 1. This is why you might wanna move them over to certain columns so that they don't get affected by Beatrice. All right, so that's how this works. Now, you could, in a turn, place one of your workers here so that you don't get affected by this card. Everyone else still will. All right. Now, just some interesting thing about cards. They deal mostly with iconography and moving down you guys down the track. So here you can move a person on the red down 1. Here, according to dogs or horse symbols, you can go down the track, so on and so on and so on. Again, black goes on your player board. Whites are one-time use only. So that's everything you need to know about this module. Let's go to the next one. All right, lastly, the possession module, which is probably the most intricate because there's most things going on here. So again, setup, set according to the player count here. So there's 2-3 players, 4-5 on the other side. You're gonna hand everyone 1 set of these possession tokens here. So there's letters on the back here. So for example, here I gave red player all the ones with the A on the back, and hand them over all some money according to the player count. Alright, some extra things during setup. The cards, just like every other module, put according to the what's written on the card slot. So there's one black card. And then you'll have four possessions here on the track. You'll take these from the stack of possessions that you'll deal that you'll have here. Alright. Also, lastly, there is this wheel over here for the burrow discount. Just set it up randomly at the start of the game, and every single round they'll just go to the next one, and it'll just keep flowing around and around and around. Alright, so what's the goal of this module? Is to lose all your money and all your possessions. So your end score here will be the amount of money you have plus every possession you have, but every possession will have some coinage added to it. It's not a straight up calculation here, so just make sure to calculate that correctly. And how do you do that? Well, you're going to be doing two things. You're going to be exchanging your possessions for possessions of lower value, and you're just going to be losing money. All right, so let's just talk about all these things that you can do. So whenever you see a coinage symbol here, you just lose money. So at the start of the game, you start with four. So if I put my token here, you just lose a dollar. You can also lose extra coins for every time symbol you spend as well. So there's some cards that give you time symbol, so like this one here, so that'll lose you an extra dollar. All right, the other two type of actions are displayed all here. You can exchange for possessions of lower value, and you can sell your own possessions. So let's talk about selling possessions first, because it's super easy. You're gonna just look at your possession. They all have a value marker on them. So this one is $5, for example. Just look at the coinage here, and you'll sell it. If you take this spot, you sell it at a negative one discount, which is great because you're trying to lose money. And if the symbol on the top right of the token here matches the current burrow discount, you'll also lose a dollar. So for example, I can sell this for three instead of five, because negative one and then another negative one because it's the red one. All right, so that's how the selling works. There's one here and there's one here. This allows you to perform two sells. All right, now exchanging, there is an exchange rate coin here. I'll show you how that works. So here you can exchange one of your possessions with any possession that's here. For example, if I want to exchange the chef for a horse, I'm essentially exchanging something of value five for something of value two, which is great because I'm losing money. Let's say I perform this exchange. Now, this is legal if I place it here because it's negative three. So this is a two for a five, so the difference is three. If I went to perform this action and I performed it at a negative two right here, it's still legal, but I need to take an extra coin from the back bank because I was only allowed to exchange for two. So any other difference above that, I would have to take coins straight from the bank. All right, so those are how all these actions work. They're all losing money. So here, this guy can just tap every turn to lose money, and they all deal with symbols on losing money and gaining time to lose more money. There you go, that's this module. It's pretty simple, actually. So that's it. So let's go to the next part. Okay, well, those are all the rules. That was kind of long and arduous. Sorry about that. Just a couple of overview things. So remember, we're picking two out of three modules or playing with all three, and certain aspects of the game are going to be added or removed by doing so. Okay, so if you do want a shorter game, usually what I would recommend is go with two, any two that you want. And if you don't mind playing all five rounds, usually all the modules together is the way to go. One thing I did forget to mention that I just realized now is that the cards, you can carry over max four from turn to turn. Very important. That's the magic number four. And that's it. So go to my other video for the playthrough and review, or I'll see you on the next video. Later.